Do you want to improve the performance of your SOA composite applications? Would you like to avoid disk reads and writes and leverage the coherence cache in SOA? Oracle SOA Suite 12.2.1 offers a new in-memory SOA feature that greatly improves performance and database maintenance, reduces database growth rate, and allows better scaling of the cluster. It enables short-running processes to live in memory. In-memory SOA provides the ability to run synchronous and asynchronous instances in memory by leveraging WebLogic coherence. These instances can live in memory and get written to the database only when faulted or at regular intervals using a write-behind thread. To configure processes for in-memory execution, there are three simple steps to perform. Design the process to be non-transactional, set the persistence flag at the component level, and turn on the in-memory flag in Enterprise Manager. Oracle JDeveloper 12c allows processes to be designed as non-transactional by adding the bpel.config.transaction property as not supported to each of the bpel processes. To handle the consequences of no transaction, the bpel process may require the fault handling to be changed before deploying the in-memory enabled application. In the same way, set the persistence flag at the component level by adding the bpel.config.completionPersist policy property as faulted, so that only faulted transactions are persisted to the database immediately. Once composite applications have been configured for in-memory execution, a SAR file is created and deployed by using Enterprise Manager to a SOA domain that's enabled to execute process in memory. As the administrator, on the Enterprise Manager SOA Infrastructure SOA Administration Common Properties page, clicking Advanced Configuration Properties opens the MBEAN page, where the in-memory environment property is set to true. After the in-memory flag is enabled and applied to the environment, the in-memory application instances aren't visible in the Flow Instances page unless they've faulted, have been dehydrated programmatically, or due to application logic. If any in-memory instances have faulted, as administrator, recover them from the Flow Trace page, or by using the normal error hospital recovery processes that enable bulk recovery. To summarize, the key steps to enable the in-memory feature are: the developer modifies the application to set the required in-memory and transactional properties by using JDeveloper. The developer generates an application SAR file that's deployed to the SOA domain by the SOA administrator. And the SOA administrator turns on the in-memory flag in Oracle Enterprise Manager. For more information, visit the Oracle SOA Suite product page and Oracle Learning Library resources. Thank you for watching.